So this afternoon we're going to sharpen and recalibrate our shoulder plane. Anytime I cut joinery, I like to intentionally leave everything big and then trim it to get a good, tight, perfect fit. And the shoulder plane is great for that. but just like anything else, the sharper and the better calibrated and better set up this tool is, the better it'll do. So to get started, we want to make sure our sole is perfectly flat and a perfect 90 degree angle to our sides. Using our double square here, I can go ahead and look at it and tell it's pretty close. So we'll get started on flattening it using our water stones. To keep track of how flat it is, I'll draw diagonal lines across the sole with the Sharpie. I want to leave my blade in here for this, but I want to make sure it's retracted beneath the sole. And I'll tighten it down as I regularly would. Our stones are nice and flat here. I just got done flattening them. I'll start off with my 4000. This should be in pretty good shape. This isn't the first time I set this up. And like most tools, we have a little dip in the center of it here. So we'll lap that until it's nice and flat. Now that the sole is nice and flat, we're going to polish the sides of it. The shoulder plane works by cutting a perfect degree 90 where the cheek and shoulder of a tendon meet. Since this blade protrudes out both sides of the plane, we're going to go ahead and remove the blade for this. And while it's out, we'll sharpen it. So with the blade out, we'll check it for square, and it seems to be pretty dead on according to this double square here, which is as good as I'm going to get. So we'll treat the sides the same way we did the sole. These Norton stones make quick work of flattening this plane. It doesn't hurt when you start out with a good quality tool. With the sole and sides flat and polished on our shoulder plane, we can move on to our blade now. This thing, if you look close, that's already got a mirror finish on it. So it really doesn't need a whole lot more as far as the bite goes. But we're just going to touch it up to get any little scratches out of it. Nice flat water stone here, our 4000 grit. Let's hold it flat against it. It's in good shape, so it don't take much.
got a new honing guide in today that we're going to use to hone the bevel on this. So it may take a little bit more work than it actually should, just because every guide's going to give you a little bit different of an angle. I don't think the angle is nearly as critical as the consistency. So that's why we may have to take this a little bit further down today than we usually would. Do this step, but just to see where our angle that we honed before compared to our new angle is, we're going to cover it, color in the bevel with a Sharpie. It also helps me to show the camera what I'm doing. We'll start out with our 4,000 grit stone again. May have to go down, and this may be enough. It just depends on where this angle is compared to our last honing guide. And we're removing a pretty good amount of it. So we'll spend some time here on the 4,000 grit, get pretty much the whole bevel down, and then we'll move up to the 8,000. Nice and sharp, we can get ready to start putting everything back together. I like to go over everything first, make sure I wipe all the schwarf, all the water away, that way nothing gets rusted. Blade drops right down in place. Put our lever cap back into place. Set these up, I always like to leave my blade really shallow, and I'll just take it out as needed. So we're getting a little bit of a shaving right there. I'll advance it just a little bit. So there they are, they're shavings. That's ready to go to work. It's a nicely tuned Taytools shoulder plane. I use this on almost every project and it's great. I'd recommend it to anybody. So there's a setup process for it. It's fairly straightforward, not too complicated. So if you're going to work with hand tools, it's really important to make sure that they're sharp and set up right. It'll really make everything a whole lot easier. So there you go. If you have any questions on how I done this or how I set up any other tools, feel free to message me. I'll be glad to answer any questions. I hope you enjoy this. I hope it helps you. So until next time, be careful.